I'm Kendall Koppe, and I run an eponymous gallery space here in Glasgow. I'm presenting an exhibition of Emory Douglas's work for Glasgow International. In 2006, I was part of an artist group called Washington Garcia, and we established an artist-run space in the city where we nomadically moved throughout the city, hosting exhibitions, different international projects, and that had a lifespan of about 4 years. And after that, I continued with the gallery, changed the name, and started representing and working with a lot of the artists that I had worked with at some point over Washington Garcia as a mode of continuing to support those artists beyond the project phase. And so I established the gallery here in 2010.
My name is Emory Douglas. I'm a former Minister of Culture and Revolutionary Artist for the Black Panther Party during the 1960s. And I'm still doing art that has a social content to it.
I've been familiar with Emory's work throughout my childhood, but I never knew it was Emory's. I'd kind of been seeing bits and bobs of it throughout New York while I was growing up. And in 2008, I was back in New York and came across a show of his at the New Museum. And I was just kind of blown away by the party's political message and its growing political agenda. So when Glasgow International approached me to do a project with them, Emory sprung to mind immediately. And I started reading about the party, and I just felt that the message the party was portraying in later on in life felt very pertinent to what was happening today. This idea of unity and self-governance and change, it just felt that people today were very kind of disenchanted with their government and disenchanted with life in general, or the kind of events that had happened in the last few years. And I just felt that message was still relevant.
I always allow the curators to make the decision on what the choices they want to use, because there are over 400 and something images that were done during that period. And some of them earlier did with this period, particularly deal with the self-defense. And we have those that dealt with social programs, solidarity with people's struggles around the world, and with the political issues that we were confronted with during that particular time. The mural work came about when Kendall got in touch with the people, I believe, in Nottingham, and they got him in touch with an artist that they had done, who had done another mural of one of my images prior to my going to Nottingham Contemporary.
Emory's illustrations and litho plates used to appear on the back cover and the front cover and the center spread. And so this one was, I think, 1970?
Yes, the time? Around 1970,
uh-huh. 1970, yes.
And... about dealing with the issue of the police, tax squad, special units that they had developed, who could go around, frisk you, stop you anytime you want. Profiling, same thing you have going on today, where you have over 6,000 people last year in New York alone who was profiled, particularly in the poor and people of color in New York, being stopped for no reason at all. And so you had that same thing happening 45 years ago in San Francisco, all across the country.
And Seize the Time was part of the party's motto.
That was, a matter of fact, that was the title of Bobby Seale's first book called Seize the Time. Mm-hmm. And Bobby Seale was the co-founder of the Black Panther Party, along with Huey P. Newton, in October of 1966.